Francis May, Simply Sherry, helping you stop living in chaos one organizing project at a time. I have another stock up haul, and I had a question asking why I am stocking up so much. Actually, I wish I could stock up more, but I'm just staying within the budget that I've always had for my groceries. So in the past, I've had a prepper pantry, but it's only been food and supplies up to 6 months. It's never gone past that. So now I've been more intentional, and I am using my budget for the current month's groceries, and then the 0 to 1 year supply, the 1 to 5 year supply, and then the long-term supply, which is 5+ years, including the tools and the jars and accessories that I'm using to do the long-term food storage. In this stock up haul, I'm going to be showing you baking supplies and breakfast items that I'll be storing for midterm, 1 to 5 years, and for long-term, 5+ years. These items are from Walmart and Costco. I do have one thing here, the brake bleeder, which is from Amazon. Let's start here on the left. So what I did was to get a blank calendar, and I listed out what we usually eat for breakfast. We're not big breakfast eaters, but on Saturdays and Sundays, I do try to make a bigger breakfast, which includes eggs and maybe sausage or pancakes and French toast. So all of that is not going to be here, like the eggs or even the bread. That's something that we could either make or keep buying on our regular grocery runs. So here, when I listed out the oatmeal, I think I would do this in a separate video, just showing the menu, how I calculated it, and how I ended up buying this amount. So I'm trying to stock up for 3 months worth of breakfast. We have old-fashioned oats, and I had started buying these from Walmart and decided might as well just go to Costco and grab it because it is a better price. Then I have the crusties, I don't even know how to say that, the buttermilk pancake mix, because you just have to add water. I also have here some cornstarch. My daughter does the baking, and so that's about the amount that we use. Probably we use less than that in 3 months, and then baking soda. So I got some baking soda also from the Dollar Tree. I'll show you that in a different haul, but this we use for baking and of course also for cleaning. And then got peanut butter because my family uses peanut butter for breakfast, like in the oatmeal. And so what I did was I observed my family for the last couple months, specifically the last month, and calculated what we're really using. So aside from the written calculations, I also looked at what my family was using during the month, and based off of that, I did my shopping. Here we have frozen blueberries, and I'll probably have to go back for one, if not two of those, but I'm waiting for the deep freezer that we're getting from my mom to be able to get more frozen food and even more meat, because right now my regular freezer would not fit everything that I'm trying to stock up. But I'll probably add one or two blueberries, one more bacon, one of those, and one of those, which is gonna be way more for 3 months, but I thought I might as well get it now. Maybe that will be going towards my 6 month supply. And then here I got Honey Nut Cheerios. So the other box I've already put into our OXO container. And they were out of Honey Nut Cheerios. They just had regular ones, which I don't like. That's basically the only cereal that I like. And this is the cereal that my daughter likes. I'll probably get one more box of that. And here you will see also here in the maple syrup. Okay. And that will be enough for the 3 months. I have here sausage links and then the veggie original sausage patties from Morningstar. Those are pretty good. And I got this non-fat dry milk. I didn't check out other stores. I went ahead and just got this online from walmart.com, picked it up curbside. This was $15.98 for 4 pounds. So I don't normally buy dry milk, so I didn't realize that was the price. Is that about a good price? Because I wasn't sure, it seemed a little bit expensive for me. And then I grabbed some almond milk, the shelf stable kind. And then as far as the sugar and the flour, I got 25 pounds and 25 pounds because in the summer my daughter was doing a lot of baking and it was about 4 pounds total for sugar. I wasn't sure about the flour, so I just got the even amount of pounds. And then I want to get more, but I stopped with that because I've just been trying to find mason jars. So if you can see all these mason jars, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put these into the mason jars. These are more for long-term food storage, not necessarily for the next 3 months. And I'll tell you what I've been doing with the mason jars. It looks like a lot, but this is a lot of work to gather these mason jars. I'm sure as you guys have probably tried to find mason jars, they're not easy to come by. So I have 3 Walmarts near me. Near meaning within a 20-minute drive, okay? So what I do is I go on walmart.com and I order the wide mouth Kerr mason jars, which is the one I tend to like. And they ask if you want a substitution. So I click yes. And then the next morning when they go to bag it, if it's not there, they will substitute it. And if I see, then when I go to pick it up curbside, they'll say, do you like the substitution? And I'll say yes or no. And then they work it out with the refund and all that and charge your card or not. So it's perfect. So that's one of my tips for finding a mason jar or finding mason jars in Walmart is just go ahead, go to walmart.com, order it. If it's out of stock, it's out of stock. If it says it's in stock and it allows you to order, go ahead and choose substitution because they'll either do a ball or a Kerr or a regular mouth versus a wide mouth, a pint versus a quart, whatever they have, they'll substitute it and they'll get your confirmation before they actually put it in your car, which I think is perfect because it saves you the time and, you know, just a lot of effort and even gas. And then another thing I do is I literally go to the store. So I pick a store for the week that I'm going to because it's been hot in Arizona. It's cooled down. So, I mean, it's hot to go out in 110 degrees and look for mason jars. So I've been doing it every week and I pick one store and I try to go on a Tuesday afternoon or a Monday. A Tuesday afternoon or a Wednesday. I just figured people still deliver on Tuesdays. The other thing I do is once a week, I pick a Walmart, one of the 3 that's in my area, and I go straight to that aisle and see if there are any mason jars. So if there are 4, I take 2, I leave 2. And so I've been fortunate. There's only 1 trip in the last month, so 3 out of 4, where there were no mason jars at all. And so I found that these Anchor Hawking ones have been the available ones, the regular mouth. So I haven't been finding the wide mouth Kerr, but that's okay. So here I found a Kerr. They substituted this Kerr regular mouth pint, which was fine, okay? So it looks like a lot of mason jars, but this was work and intention. I go on walmart.com every day and see if it's available to buy. If it is, I go ahead and click. I buy once a week, and then I go in once a week. So that is all to say that when I get more mason jars, I will get more flour and sugar to put in those mason jars. I might try the gamma lids, so I haven't tried that yet. So we'll see. That's just kind of, we're all in the process here. We're all trying to make it happen, trying to stock up. Almost forgot to show the brake bleeder. So I ordered this on Amazon. Inexpensive, so it was a good price. Someone had mentioned this, and I had actually seen a video was it Rain Country doing this? And so I went ahead and got the brake bleeder. I think this is like $10 to $15. And you basically attach the hose, pump, and that vacuum seals the mason jars versus using your food sealer. So I did both, and this requires work. So if you don't mind doing that, it works perfectly. And I love that it came with a case. I think most of them are in a case. So, and I'm glad that it was orange, like the nice bright color. So I hope you enjoyed this stock up haul. Let me know in the comments below what you usually eat for breakfast and if you're stocking up on that. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Is the clutter in your home leaving you exhausted? I can help you stop living in chaos. Go to my website and schedule a free 20-minute virtual home organizing assessment, simplysherry.com. Click the pink button, Get Organized Today. It'll bring you to a page for Calendly. Choose the time that works for you, and you will receive an email with a Zoom call link. I look forward to helping you. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.